best hotel in Guatemala City, and this is our special guest right here. This is Rich Mullins. And Rich, it's very good to have you on the program.
Well, thank you. It's very good to be here.
Rich, a lot of people don't realize, but you're also a very talented songwriter. You've written a number of songs for Amy Grant. Sing Your Praises to the Lord was a big hit. Love of Another Kind on her latest album, Doubly Good to You. And being a lyricist, do you really feel like today's Christian music is communicating in word the real message of Jesus Christ?
I think lyrically, I think a lot of people are saying everything that they're expected to say. It's like they say all the right Sunday school little things. And it's even like right and very Sunday schoolish now to say, gee, I'm questioning my faith. Seems like even our music should be distinct. And it just seems like a lot of people want to sound as much like the world as they can and still have a Christian message, which maybe that's evangelistic, but I guess because I personally have a real problem with really slick music and really slick lifestyles and people who are dressed in all the right clothes and all the, you know, being very in, because I think Jesus reaches to the people who are very out.
Such a thing as glory.
A song that we're going to take a look at in video form here. It's called The Other Side of the World, and I'd like you to set that up for our audience, if you would.
That was a song that I wrote. It's kind of everything came together in the time that I got to spend in the Orient. Everything kind of came together one morning. We're getting ready to be in a worship service where there were going to be Shan and Lisu and Lahu and Chinese and Northern Thai and English-speaking people and I just really began all of a sudden to get a grasp of what the church was doing. I was kind of overwhelmed. And then tonight, seeing again, being with Christians and seeing that there is power in the body of Christ when we come together and He does equip us, then you go, yeah, there is hope. And I'm very thankful to be a part of a movement of people that's being directed by God.
Atitan de Prajao, Le Kunjo Sabai. Atitan de Prajao, Le Kunjo Sabai. Cherma, Cherma, Malong do see. Cherma, Cherma, see my long do. Atitan de Prajao, Le Kunjo Sabai.
Well, the other side of the world is not so far away as I thought that it was. As I thought that it was so far away. The other side of the world is not so far away. And the distance just dissolves into the love, into the love. And the new Jerusalem won't be as easy to build as I hoped it would be. As I hoped it would be easy to build. New Jerusalem won't be so easy to build. There's many bellies to fill and many hearts to free. Gotta set them free. But I see a people who have learned to walk in faith with mercy in their hearts. Not as prone to prevail as I thought that they were, as I once thought they were prone to prevail. But I know that the gates of hell, they have been destined to fail. I see Satan impaled on the sword of the word, on the sword of the word. And I see the people who have learned to walk in faith with mercy in their hearts. The other
And if I sing, let me sing for the joy that is born in me these songs. And if I weep, let it be as a man who is longing for his home.
We're here at the Guatemala City dump, and as you can see behind me, this is home for a lot of the people here. And we're with Rich Mullins. And Rich, you have the unique opportunity of influencing a lot of young people through your music. And I want to ask you a question. Do you feel like the contemporary Christian musician as a whole is doing their part to present a missionary vision and impact to today's young people?
I mean, I think there are a lot of people out there who are really doing their best and who are really showing the people in the United States that there are needs. I think there are a lot of people representing World Vision, for example, and they have a great program, I think, for just educating people in the United States as the needs. I think primarily responsibility for missions still is with the church, but I do see a lot of people who are doing a lot of good things.
You know, when you look around and see the tremendous needs beyond our own borders, you know, I've never seen anything like this in the United States. And when you see it, you say, man, there's a need. But what should our response be as Christians in the United States? I mean, what do we say to this now that we have knowledge? You know, we're accountable. What should our response be to someone that may be watching the program?
Well, I think Christ, the parable of the rich man and Lazarus is very vivid. And I think I have a hard time understanding how people who live with so much as we do think that they can get by without judgment when people live like this. And not that we are ever going to be able to alleviate poverty, because some people choose poverty. I mean, it's their chosen lifestyle. But there are people right here next to us that have not chosen this. And if we turn our backs on them, we're turning our backs on Christ.
Whether you fall down or whether you fly, it seems you can never get too far.
I think, first of all, I think every Christian is called to, I think that is the commission that was given to the church. And if you are a Christian, you are a member of the church, and you are responsible to see that the world is reached. And I think, of course, there's financial backing. There's, you know, I think there are a lot of missionaries. There are a lot of people who are here working who are very frustrated and very lonely, and you can support them by writing letters to them, supporting them. It's, you know, God calls us each to give what we have of our resources. And
You said something real interesting there. You said everyone is called to go, and that's right. The Bible said that all Christians go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Would you go as far to say that if God hasn't said no, we should be going?
I know some people who I really respect who do say that. I think that we have to see that as the body of Christ is going, and which means that there are going to be people who are going to be here in Guatemala. There are going to be people in Korea. I think there are also going to need to be people in the United States. I guess the United States is a mission field. Yeah. I guess we're not as Christian as sometimes we think we are, maybe.
sacred ears will listen and holy hands reach out to touch. How can I keep myself from singing? Hallelujah! 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 I see the moon. How can I keep myself from singing? Hallelujah.